Okay, so I've managed to actually pin down the musical director for Reading Operatic's next production, which is Little Shop of Horrors, and this is Mr. Thomas Joy. Hello.
Hello, Angie. How are you?
I'm very good, thank you. Great to finally sit down and chat to you before curtain goes up on the production. We need to get a little bit of an insight from a musical director's point of view, everything that goes into this show. So, first of all, what made you decide to take on this project with Reading Operatic?
So this show has been one of my absolute favourites for years now. Ever since I saw it back when I was a student at university, I've always wanted to do it. So when the opportunity came up to do it with Reading, absolutely took it. I think I snatched it out of Nikki's hand and said, absolutely yes, desperate to do it.
So a bit of a no-brainer, really.
Oh, exactly, exactly. As soon as I got the opportunity, I was signed up as quick as I could.
So a lot of people who perhaps don't know who are responsible for music and lyrics, can you give us a little bit of an insight in who's responsible for the composition of this musical?
Absolutely. So the genius behind the score is Alan Menken, who is of course one of the Disney legends, the man behind Beauty and the Beast, Little Mermaid, and all of the sort of the great Renaissance era Disney films from the 90s, as well as the more recent musicals. So for example, Sister Act, the show that went up in the West End a few years ago now. So yes, he's behind the score, and it's an absolutely brilliant score as well.
Any particular favourites from the show that you really do enjoy? Any particular numbers, or is that a difficult question?
It's definitely a difficult question, but the one that really stands out for me is right at the beginning of the show, you have Downtown. Mm-hmm. We're really lucky that we've actually made a lot of these numbers full company numbers. Mm-hmm. And it's one of those numbers that everyone gets involved. The choreography is brilliant, and the harmonies that are in there as well are absolutely fantastic. It sounds brilliant. It changes quite a lot all the way through. And yeah, I think it's going to be one of those that are really going to sort of make the audience sit up and pay attention to sort of the quality of what's on stage for this production.
I mean, I have to say it was a no-brainer for me to support and get involved with sort of talking to you all, because it is one of my favourite shows, because you hit the nail on the head earlier on, and that was the harmonies are, they're great, but they're actually quite difficult to learn, aren't they, would you say?
Yeah, definitely. But you know what, I've got an exceptionally hard-working and talented cast, I have to say, who every time that I kind of push them that bit further, they always sort of respond and give me more. So it's been an absolute joy and a thrill to work with them all.
Oh, superb. Well, I mean, I can't wait to see the production, because obviously it's one of my favourites. Mm-hmm. It's lovely also to chat to you again, because obviously we've worked together before
indeed.
On some very challenging musical numbers, haven't
definitely,
we?
Definitely.
And I have to say, one of my favourites from Little Shop is the finale, Don't Feed the Plants.
Yes.
It's a real chance for everybody just to come together and really go for it, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. And do you know what? There's a few parts of the song where all of a sudden the music cuts out and you're just left with the vocal of the people on stage, and they've worked so hard and it sounds fantastic. They are really tricky harmonies.
They are.
And sort of from a musical director's point of view, where I'm sort of thinking, when you start rehearsing, you don't know a cast necessarily. It's like, well, do I need to simplify this? Do we maybe need to take out a couple of the harmony lines just to make it that bit easier to teach? But you know what? This cast have just responded so well and it sounds fantastic.
Well, massive congratulations. Can't wait to see it. I will be there. And I hope from a musical point of view, you really do have a fantastic experience, and all the best, Thomas.
Thanks, Angie.
I've managed to collar two of the other most important people in putting on a production with Reading Operatic Society, and that is our lovely director, which is Nikki.
Hello.
Hi, Angie.
And our choreographer, Dylan.
Hello.
All right, lovely to meet you two. I know that you've got quite a heavy rehearsal schedule booked in for today, but let's just have a little bit more of an insight into the production from these two key roles that you both have. Why Little Shop of Horrors, Nikki?
Oh, I love this musical. So I'm a bit of a nerd, love sci-fi, and obviously love musicals as well. So Little Shop was a great opportunity. And we wanted to do something a bit different with it as well. So some really unusual ideas that you wouldn't normally see in a production of Little Shop. So I was excited to try those out.
And for anybody who doesn't know what Little Shop of Horrors is about, in a very sort of brief synopsis of the musical, are you able to tell me and our listeners, obviously, what is Little Shop of Horrors about?
Oh, without giving too much away, it's about a small flower shop in New York that's kind of a bit down and out. It isn't doing particularly well, and then Seymour, who works at the shop, one day buys this plant, mysterious plant that comes to him, and he puts it on display in the shop, and suddenly everybody loves it, everybody's interested in it, they're starting to make the shop loads of money, but something about the plant isn't quite right. I won't give away any more than that. They need to come and watch the show.
Absolutely. Because yeah. Obviously there was a musical film, wasn't there,
in, yeah, exactly.
in the 1980s. And I think for those that are familiar with it, had some quite interesting actors, well-known actors playing the parts.
Yeah.
And it has gone from strength to strength, hasn't it? From a movie to a stage version. And I think if I'm right, the stage version, the ending is quite different to the movie.
It is, yes. There's a different musical number at the end. So if you haven't seen the musical version of it, slightly different ending. Mm-hmm. But I think the reason the movie was so successful, you had people like Steve Martin, Rick Moranis, and in those principal roles. Mm-hmm. And nothing like that had really been on screen in terms of sci-fi musicals back then. Mm-hmm. But nowadays, I think it's got lots of interesting themes in it, which mm-hmm. what makes mm-hmm. it really popular.
Yeah.
And it applies to lots of different audiences, I think.
Yeah, exactly. So it's got a bit of been cult following now as well, mm-hmm. which is great. Yeah.
Right, so when did you start rehearsals and casting? When did that all begin?
That was back in October.
I know.
So we ran...
It
does. Such a long time ago. So we ran a few workshops, which were really popular. We were really pleased. And then auditioned and began really in November mm-hmm. with the rehearsal process. So lots to learn over 4 or 5 months.
Yeah. It feels like a long time when you think about it, but actually it flies by, it really does.
Yeah. And cast, I think you've got quite unique production because what, small cast?
It is for Reading Ops, yes. Yeah. We've got a cast of 13. Mm. So if you've seen Reading Ops do shows at the Hexagon, we've got 40 or 50 people on stage. It's a completely different production to that. Mm. But we've been incredibly lucky. Yeah, our cast are just phenomenal.
Yeah.
So we've got a small cast, but very, very talented. And they make a lot of beautiful sounds and very talented dancers and actors as well. So yeah, we're very, very lucky.
Yes. And that leads me on nicely to my next question, Dylan. Obviously, you are a key player in putting all the dance and choreography together. Taken any inspiration from anywhere, or is this all your own work this time?
No, I don't try not to watch any other productions of Little Shop because mm. I just wanted it all to be organic. There's nothing worse than sort of seeing bits and then recognising it in your own production and thinking, oh no, I just wanted to listen to the music and can kind of find inspiration from that.
Another good reason why people should come and see it then, because
yes,
exactly. It's all unique Reading Operatic work. Yeah, okay. Where is it showing? Where can we come and see this amazing production?
You can see this fantastic production at the Kenton Theatre in Henley on March the 18th to the 21st. So Wednesday to Saturday, yep. With a Saturday matinee as well.
Okay, and one final question. I was so intrigued. Obviously, I know this show. How have you gone about creating the Audrey 2? What have you done?
Oh, that's a question for you.
Because it's quite a challenge, isn't it, mm-hmm. when you've got to sort of get this transported into a theatre and built or whatever. But how have you gone about, acquiring an Audrey 2?
Yes, so I know various directors approach us in different ways. Sometimes you have just a voice of Audrey 2. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you'll have an actual actor on stage. And I've seen it done both ways. So what we've got is a little bit of a hybrid. The actor playing Audrey 2 is Charlie Woodward. Again, just stunning vocals. And she will be appearing on stage, but only when she's speaking to Seymour. So the idea behind having Charlie on stage was that she is a bit of a vision in Seymour's head, and mm-hmm. it's how he thinks Audrey 2 would look. Mm-hmm. So you'll notice that she isn't necessarily always on stage whilst talking.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Air of mystery.
Very creative. Okay, well, I wish you all the best. It's a pleasure to sit down and chat to you again and to support you. I will be there to come and see your version of Little Shop of Horrors because I absolutely love the production. All the best with rehearsals and, yeah, break a leg.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much, Angie.
Okay. Cheers.
Here we go. I've managed to catch three of the key cast members from the production Little Shop of Horrors. We have, who have I got on my right?
I'm Holly and I play Audrey.
My name's Zach, I'm playing Oren.
And my name's Tom, I'm playing Seymour.
So we've got some obviously key characters here. Give us a little insight what it's like being playing Audrey.
Playing Audrey is quite an interesting challenge because, she's one of the only kind of lead female roles in the show, so there's quite a lot of time on stage and there's many different facets to Audrey because you know, she's in a very abusive relationship with Oren at the time, but also she has a secret passion for Tom's character Seymour as well, so you're playing against those two feelings of against two men, which is quite challenging.
Okay, and how have you gone about sort of the script and the lines? Has it been okay learning it all? Has it been a challenge, or is it with the time you've got?
There are quite a lot of lines and there are quite a lot of songs and harmonies, so it has been a challenge sort of learning everything, but Thomas has been great providing us with harmonies and vocals to learn in the car, so being in the car quite a lot has been quite handy, actually being able to learn some of the lyrics and the songs in my own time. But yeah, there is a lot to learn.
And coming to you, Zach, obviously the last time we met was on the production of Little Shop of Horrors together. You were playing quite a different character to what you're playing this time. Yeah. Quite good to embrace and take on something a bit different from the last production that you did of it.
Well, yeah, I guess. So last time before I was Audrey too, which ultimately, no spoilers, but he's got a dark side. but this one's quite openly got a dark side. It's been quite fun, if I'm honest. No, everyone enjoys playing the bad guy, I think, really. Yeah, it's been a good process, and I just get to mess around until I'm told that's too far, really. And that's fine.
That's what it's about, isn't it? Yeah, how far can you push it, really?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, brilliant. And singing-wise, obviously, again, have you found that it's been quite good fun embracing and the challenges of the vocals from this character?
Yeah, he's got quite a distinct sort of style to his mannerisms and his voice, and I think incorporating that into the songs it's been fun. But again, it's just a chance to mess around, really.
Yeah.
It's fun.
Super. And finally, Seymour.
Yeah.
First time you've been playing Seymour from Little Shop of Horrors?
Oh, yeah, to be fair, I've never really done a main role in any show before, so this is kind of the first time I've had to do it, which is great. But yeah, lots to learn. Didn't realise. Hadn't even seen the film before I auditioned, so... like, didn't realise how many songs there were, how many lines there were, which has been pretty crazy. But yeah, it's been, somehow we are at this point where we're so close to the date and it's looking really good.
Ultimately, guys, you're having a really good crack. It's really good fun, yeah?
Oh yeah, definitely.
It's all right, yeah. Sometimes.
Thanks for
joining
us.
No, it's really good.
Oh, well, I wish you well. I certainly will be bopping away, I'm sure, when you all, going to come and see the production, because I think it's absolutely great. It's a great score, and all the characters are thoroughly entertaining. So thanks for your time. Break a leg, and I wish you all the best with the show.
Thanks, Angie.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.